In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a grainy texture in After Effects, so let's get to it. First, let's create a new composition. It will be 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second. Then select the shape tool. I'm actually going to click and hold until I see the drop down and select the ellipse tool. I'm going to set fill to a solid color and set color to be white. For the stroke, I'm going to set it to none. Then from the center of the composition, I'm going to click and drag, holding Ctrl and Shift keys at the same time to create the ellipse with proportional dimensions, which I'm going to center using the Align tab. I'm also going to rename it to Ellipse, then click Erase, make sure you're not highlighting the shape layer, then select the Pen tool, set Fill Color to be black, and then create a shape layer like this. After that, let's open Effects and Presets window, search for Roughen Edges, add it to the shape layer above the ellipse, and search for Set Matte. Also add it to the shape layer, then head over to the Effect Controls panel and make sure that the effects are placed in such an order. So the Roughen Edges comes first, then comes the Set Matte. So in the Set Matte, we're going to set Take Matte from Layer to the ellipse or any main shape that you have. That'll make sure that the shape layer that we created, the black one, is only visible on top of the ellipse. Then for the Roughen Edges, I'm going to set Border to 250 and scale all the way to 10, and that gives us a very nice grainy texture. But if we preview this, it is not animated, it's just a stale image at the moment, so we're going to animate the grain. We can use that using the evolution or a random seed for the evolution. So I'm actually going to animate the random seed, so I'm going to hold the Alt key and click on the random seed stopwatch. That'll enable us to add expression, which is time asterisk 10, then click away. And now if we preview, the grainy texture will be nicely animated. So if you want it to go faster, you can increase the value. So instead of 10, put something like 20 or 30. Now we also need to parent the grainy texture to the main shape. So in this case, the ellipse. So if you don't see parent and link option, right click, go to colon to make sure parent and link option is checked. Then you'll see this colon, drag this pick whip from the shape layer to the ellipse or the main shape that you have. And now if we select the ellipse, press P on the keyboard and try to animate it, you can see that the grainy texture moves with it. And also if you want to adjust the grainy texture, you can always select the shape layer and select the pen tool. And now you are able to manipulate the points. And here, give it a different look. So add more grain if you wish to do so. You can also come back to the effect controls panel and play around with the border size, whether you increase or decrease it. So that's up to you and your personal preferences. And that is how you create a grainy texture in After Effects. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thank you guys for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.